In honor of Women's History Month, we've been talking with female leaders in sports, politics, business, and entertainment. And this morning, we are focusing on...
Every Friday during Women's History Month...
long, we've been celebrating Women's History Month by talking with female leaders in sports, politics, business, and entertainment. And
something that I don't see. What can you learn from a bum, Omar? Shamsuddin? What I learned from a bum, maybe it's what not to do.
Down Angel Snuff Nuff 7 easy. There's a reason why, after 100 channels destroyed, Angel Snuff Nuff 7 is still here. There's a reason why nobody want to get in a beef with Angel Snuff Nuff 7. But you don't take me seriously.
You can't touch this. touch this. Can't touch this. Can't touch this.
See, they say that Angel Snuff Nuff 7 don't care about the people. But Angel Snuff Nuff 7 cares about the people because I'm bold enough to tell you the truth and I don't give a damn if you give me a dime. I'm not looking for your money.
I know you got soul. dance. I want that. Oh, I need that. Guts to have that. It's me. Because I keeps it real like that. I keeps it real.
Snuff Nuff 7 at the Reality Temple. And to give props to him, because I listen to all of Angel Snuff Nuff 7's videos, I think that he comes from a different angle. And there's a powerful message in a lot of the videos that he put out, and I try to catch all of them. I look at him as a free thinker and a person that's willing to challenge those of which he don't agree with or which he may think differently from, and I really respect him for that. He's challenged KNBS, and he has also challenged the black supremacy movement as well. And I have nothing against that, because that which cannot be challenged cannot stand and will not stand and will not survive the test of time. How many challenges we can withstand will determine how long we will be able to stand.
I want to talk to
you. I know who the enemy is.
I want to talk to
you. You're wasting your time making mockery of me. Oh, I'm crazy. My brain is damaged. My Envo poster. I'm miserable in my life. All this nonsense that you talk about. And you a slave, just like me, in a racist nation.
That is Brother Talik from the Reality Temples on Earth channel. And if you get a chance to subscribe, please do subscribe to his channel. He's a good brother. You know, he's doing good work, and he wants to do good constructive things. He has good information to provide. So please do check out his channel if you get a chance.
Fire. I'm a power man, no. should evolve into what we call the reality's temple on earth. You don't need no Arab hand-me-down religion. You don't even need God. You don't need these things. That's good for us in our infancy, in our immaturity, when we was babies. But as we grow in mature, and even in religion itself, it says that we are the children of God. Children can't stay children forever. Children must become adults. So if we are the children of God, that means we become God. Act like God, move like God, and have the responsibility of a God. Manifest. Welcome to the Reality's Tip on Earth, Dragon Manifest.
Thank you for having me, brother. This is an honor. When I first saw your channel, I said, oh, this is an ancestor that has most definitely returned. Yes, most sir. Definitely. This is not a new ancestor. This is an old ancestor. you could hear, you could feel the ancestors through you. You know, most people probably say, what is he talking about?
Right.
They don't get it. You gotta be on that level.
If you say that I'm divine and I'm a prophet, where the hell did your ass go to? Why aren't you heeding the call? Since I'm a prophet, since I'm divine. Some people, excuse the language, some people just like talking out their ass. 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 That's what they like to do.
Peace forever and always. My black people, it's all about the unity. It's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody moving.
This video is for the Reality Temple on Earth.
Shout out to the Reality Temple on Earth on IG.
We love watching it.
Yeah, we really do.
We send love, peace, and soul.
Brother.
Good evening, soul brothers and sisters. This is Tanji Cox, the Black Sheep. And I am propositioning you to entertain just a little while of being in reality. And this is gonna hurt soul sisters and brothers, because a lot of us cannot accept reality. I empower you to, for 1 year, to subscribe to the Reality Temple on Earth. And at the end of 12 months, draw your conclusion of what have you learned in that amount of time. I empower you. You will never, ever, ever think, feel, or entertain nonsense ever again, period. I would like to see my soul sisters and brothers awaken. This requires time. You need to spend about a year watching, researching, and looking. The Reality Temple on Earth is life-changing, and I stand on that.
ride, let's get this party started. Ride, let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started.
Ride.
Let's get this party started.
Ride.
Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started.
Ride.
Let's get this party started.
Ride.
Let's get this party started. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started.
Ride.
Let's get this party started.
Ride.
Let's get this party started quickly.
Let's see. Talik says, can you send a shout out to my platform, the Realities Temple on Earth Internet Ministry? Our theme this year is After Purge Comes the Healing. So shout out to your platform, Talik. All the best to you guys with continuing to stretch in perspective, to stretch in what is possible, and to continue to bring healing into the space of yourself and others. Yes.
Begins in 3, 2, 1.
It's Women's History Month. We were just sitting here talking about who we want to highlight, commemorating and remembering brilliant women who were trailblazers in women's history. And congratulations to all of the women who have paved the way and blazed the trail. Thank you for your excellence. Thank you for the inspiration.
We have incredible Nobel Prize winner Toni Morrison.
Poets like Phyllis Wheatley and Maya Angelou. Hopefully we're making some type of mark in women's history. Musicians like Celia Cruz and Ella Fitzgerald and Sarah Vaughan, I mean, you know the list will go on. And lots of women to remember during this Women's History Month. So shout out to all this beautiful feminine energy paving the way for all ladies.
This is a story about control. My control. Control of what I say and control of what I do. And this time I'm gonna do it my way. I hope you enjoy this as much as I do. Are we ready? I am. Because it's all about control. And I've got lots of it.
In the name of my ancestors, peace forever and always. All right, let's do a mic check. Can you hear me? Welcome to another spontaneous broadcast of what we call the Realities Temple on Earth Internet Ministry. I'm the Mighty One, Angel Snub Number 7. And this is a, I was going to hold back on this topic, but this is what many call International Women's Day. This is also Women's History Month. And since this is International Women's Day, I thought this topic would be appropriate for this day. Our topic that we've chosen, it's called control, the sick need to control us. And this is why we have a International Women's Day. This is why we have a Women's History Month. Because the gender, the woman, our sisters, our mothers, our daughters, our aunts, our grandmothers in the human family have suffered oppression longer than slavery. In fact, I would say that the female probably was the first human slave. It was the female, not a male, it was the female, the first human slave. And she has been catching hell from her counterpart as far as recorded history. That's a shame. That's a shame. the female has been under oppression as far as recorded history. Wow. Welcome to the reality stuff on Earth. We bring salute to womanhood. We bring salute to our mothers and daughters, our cousins, female cousins, our aunts, grandmothers, great-grandmothers. We want to wish all those under the sound of my voice, I wish us all Happy International Women's Day. Before we get into our topic, I would like for us to do me a favor. I would like, if you don't mind, I would like for you to do me a favor. All those who are old subscribers, listeners to this broadcast, and those who are new, could you do me a favor by doing yourself a favor? And that is, whatever you hear from this platform, whether it's this video or any other topic that we've chosen on this platform, before you get angry, before you get upset, could you tell us about it? Could you tell me about it? We've had so many individuals that thought a certain way about us, and they kept it inside. And when they get angry, what they kept deep inside of them, they blow up. You shouldn't want to be like that. Not only here, but we should be sincere to our loved ones and our friends. If your friend has a hairstyle, and your friend really loved that hairstyle, but you're not feeling it, don't say, "Girl, that hairstyle is dynamite." Don't tell that person that lie. Tell them how you feel. If you are a friend, it's all right. It's all right if you're a friend to tell your friend, I really don't like that. I mean, if you like it, that's cool. I personally, I don't like the hairstyle. Because when you get angry, you're going to tell them. That hairstyle you had 2 weeks ago, that was whack. Now you're mad and you're angry. This makes us see. This makes us a liar. And we wonder why we find difficulty in our friendship, our relationships, our romantic relationships, our relationship with our children and our parents, with the people on the job, because we are liars. It is better to be truthful than to sit on something and you know that you're not being honest. So we have a person fresh among us, I mean, just constantly spitting nastiness, because this is what you was all the time. and you kept this bottled because you want something. See, some of us, we want something. Well, I would tell my boss this, but he might fire me. I would tell my mother this, but she might not cook me dinner. I might not tell my girl this because she might not do something tonight. But sooner or later, you're going to reveal who you are, because all that bottled up inside is going to come out. The theme that we've chosen since 2021 on this platform is, after the purge comes the healing. We cannot become better human beings. We cannot become better persons when we're not real with each other. Don't get angry. Then you want to spit venom. Because you're not making me look bad. You're making yourself look bad. And we know that's what you was all the time. You never was a friend. You never was a brother or a sister. You was a ticking time bomb of evil, waiting to explode. And for us, it's a good thing that you explode now and get out the way. It's a joyous time when they explode. It is like the rotten apple. If you put a rotten apple among good apples, that rotten apple will spoil the good. So we get rid of the rotten apple. Because we don't want our good to be spoiled. As they say in religion, such exposure is a blessing. And we love our friends. We do have love for our friends and our people. But sometimes it's good to separate yourself from those who don't mean you any good. And it's a wonderful thing that they show you early. Some people don't expose themselves till 20 years later. I see it on court shows all the time. People been friends 10, 15, 20, 25 years, and then they turn on somebody that was good to them for a couple of dollars. Or are they setting you up for the kill? Hey man, let me hold 20 and they pay it back. Hey man, let me hold 100 and they pay it back. Hey, can I get 100? And they pay it back. They make a pattern of paying you back. Then they go for the big one. I'm in real, real serious trouble. Can I get $5,000, bro? We've been friends for 10, 20 years. You know I'm good for you. You know I'm good for it. And you never hear from them again. So we must be careful. And we must watch for the signs of those who are sincere. Sometimes it's good just make people mad on purpose, just to see how they're going to react. So you can get rid of them. They don't mean you any good. So I can sit here in 2023 and I feel very, very well. I feel very, very good. getting rid of trash, disassociating with garbage, getting the fleas and the ticks off my skin so that we can move on as we want to do what we can to try to better ourselves as individuals. And hopefully we can become examples to show others outside what it is to be a human being. So don't keep that bottled up inside of you. Don't wait till you get angry at Angel Snuffnup 7. No matter what it is, you don't like my black shirt. You don't like my hairstyle. You don't like my Invo ladies behind me. Just get it out. Just say how you feel. Don't keep it bottled up inside yourself. You can't grow as a human being. And we see how they act and how they respond. They've been holding it in for so long, it's like a flood. And we wish to avoid the flood. I don't know it all. And those who come to this platform, I constantly say and tell you, I don't know it all. I don't make that claim. I would tell you I don't know. I plead the fifth. So it makes no sense to argue and debate when I tell you, never thought about that. I don't know. But I will, and we will defend this platform. We will defend our foundation because I know that's right. And I'm going to prove that's right. Not by a bunch of books or the information that you've been digging in the Hall of Records some damn where. Common sense and logic and reasoning. It don't take all that. They want to sound smart. Reading a book don't make you smart. Getting the information don't make you smart. It just means that you dug up some information and you can read. I applaud you. It makes no sense to get the information and you can't produce nothing. What do you produce with your information and your research and your documentation? What do you produce? You're not even a good human being. You're not even a good human being. Profane, nasty, evil, wicked person. You're not even a good human being. So what you gonna produce? You're not gonna produce nothing. Your own self is rotten. Heal yourself. Don't worry about other people. Why don't you work on yourself and become a better person? Don't know how to talk to people. Don't know how to socialize with nobody. You think because you spit some documentation and some research that you got out of a library off Google somewhere, people are supposed to be impressed. You think you smart. But if you're that smart.
Hello, everyone. The wait is over. It's finally here. Season 4 of The Family Business on BET Plus. Watch it tonight. I will be watching. See you there.
I literally feel naked without my keys. You know, this is better than gold. This is gold. I don't care if nobody say, you can't tell me this is not a platinum diamond chain. Because you know what? I walked right through those doors and I got sober. I've connected with my siblings. I have connected with my children. I have mentally and emotionally connected back with myself, which is very important. Home is everything.
I keep it real.
What, dear?
Because I keeps it real like that.
I keeps it real.
Come on now. Assemble the people, come on. We will not be defeated by witch doctors' illusions.
Whoa, don't slip up or get cut.
Why not, man?
I'm coming for that number one spot.
All right. Woo!
Rappers swearing they own tub.
But
I'm coming for that number one spot.
All right, man.
Scheme, scheme, plot, plot.
Say what?
I'm coming for that number one spot.
Woo! Hey.
Keep it going, it won't stop.
What you doing, man?
I'm coming for that number one spot.
Off Google somewhere, people supposed to be impressed. You think you smart. But if you're that smart, what do you produce? Bad or good, what do you produce? You don't produce nothing bad, and you don't produce nothing good. You don't produce nothing, period. So we ignore the children because we are adults. We ignore the children and allow them to have their temper tantrum. And we go on to better things. Welcome to the Rally's Tip on Earth. I'm Angel Snubnub 7. And the healing here continues. Happy International Women's Day. I came to YouTube in 2007. And according to YouTube analytics, how you say that? Analytics. My audience was women, mostly soul sisters, black women. And a lot of them was involved in interracial relationships. And I don't advocate interracial relationships, but they was here, and many of them probably still are listening to Angel Snubnub 7. Because Angel Snubnub 7 stands up and defends womanhood. So those women gave me the title of divine. you relate it to spirituality and godhood and all that stuff. A divine masculine is simply a male who stands up and defends the female, no more, no less. Has nothing to do with God and the spiritual world or all that kind of stuff. They gave me that title. I didn't have that. I had no need for such a title. But the women gave me that title. They gave me that gift. And I accept it. It has been womanhood that has really taken care of me all my life. And I've been raised around womanhood. I had my grandfather and uncles and people like that. But the women seemed to be more stronger and smarter and wanted more out of life. And all the women actually was doing better than the men. And I saw that. And when I got in trouble, there was no man to come to my aid. It was always a woman, my mother, or some females, always. Always. A female. During the time of the most stressful time in my life, it was four men, one so-called brother, all the men did all they could to keep me locked up. It was a woman that relieved me of incarceration. It was women, the 10 years I was locked up. It was the care of women that helped me survive incarceration. Their kindness. They're caring. And because I was raised around women all the time, when I got around or hung around males who were disrespectful to women, they didn't like being around me because I did not talk. Certain talk. You don't call a woman the H word around me or the B word around me. I don't want to hear how you go to strip clubs and put dollars in her drawers. And you gave her $10 to suck your Peter Weeder. I don't want to hear that kind of talk. I don't want to hear about you cheating on your wife and your girlfriend. We are in the situation that we're in right now here in America because a lot of men, they are foul like that. If you care about your daughter, because your daughter is going to leave your house and she's going to have to deal with the kind of man or men that you support in their exploitation and their disrespect of womanhood. and one of them will probably get her. But that's what you want, because you encourage that behavior in the brothers, in other men. You encourage that. So a good example would be like the rapper Jay-Z became a millionaire calling women the H word and B word. And you heard of stories of Jay-Z jumping from one woman to another, lying and cheating on the sisters. Well, now he has daughter. So Jay-Z, don't you get angry and upset when somebody do that to your daughter. Don't get upset, because this is what you advocate. This is what you're teaching and have taught young men in your rap career, to be trifling. So I can't, those type of men didn't like being around me. I was going to do this topic, but what made me really want to do it tonight on this International Women's Day, I was watching television and they was interviewing a young woman in Afghanistan. And she was in a factory, but she was prior to the Taliban coming back into control of Afghanistan. She was studying to be a lawyer. Now she's in a factory, which of course now, work is work, labor is labor. Don't be ashamed of what you do in your life. But she was studying and she wanted to be a lawyer. Because of the Taliban and their version of Islamic law, she can't be a lawyer. So now she works hours and hours in a factory. She's not able, because of her gender. Now she committed a crime because of her gender. I'm not allowed to do this and that because those in control. Why you don't want this young woman to be a lawyer? Why do you want to control a woman? Around the earth, if you are a wife in some parts of the earth, if you are a wife and you deny your husband sexual relations, you could be charged with a crime and you could be murdered for denying your husband. In this country, men control so much of womanhood in this country. They control women's reproductive rights. You don't have a vagina. You're not going to have a baby. But men want to dictate to women what they can and can't do with their bodies. Target because of your gender. Control. There's a sickness in the human family. And it makes no difference about skin color. You will find this all over the earth, and you will see it in history. Control. Control has become a sickness. There's nothing wrong with control. Control can be good. It is the corruption of control. Control begins in our mother's womb when the sperm first meets the egg. And as the embryo begins to develop, it has to take control of the womb. So after 9 months, everything is in the right place. So life can come into this reality. When things are out of control, then a woman has to have a cesarean section because the baby didn't turn in the right way. Or something is going wrong, something has gone out of control. But when everything is right, then life comes from the womb. In pain, but in the manner that it's supposed to come. So we come into life into control. Our mother is our first teacher, but she's also the first one to control us. She control when you're gonna eat, but she control when you're gonna eat, when that diaper gonna get changed. She control all those things. So for us, it's out of our control because we have no power. But if you have a good mother, it's all right for her to be in control. But then we have parents, we have mothers. You can cry and they will take their time feeding you. They don't want to hold you. They don't want to clean your dirty diaper. Now your life is out of control. You got a father that might give his children liquor because they control you. You have no power. Now see here, I could go on Google, I could go get a dictionary, and we could look up the actual definition of control. We're not gonna do that. We have an idea that's good enough. You have people, they want to get all technical. Well, you know, it control actually comes from the Latin word. It's so lovely. Just keep it going. Years, and the first person that talked about control was Aesop Supernapius. Who cares? If you want that, you can find all those Hasidic channels on YouTube. We don't do that here. We just keep it simple, because I want to talk to you, because you're not dumb. See, I don't want to talk to you and try to act like I'm Mr. Smart Guy. I want to get all these books and quote from these books, and I got this from this library, and try to impress you. That's not necessary. All of us have a certain amount of knowledge and things already. We don't have to get technical like that. If you want to get technical like that, take your happy ass to college and university. And if you notice, most of these people don't have college degrees. They didn't go to a university. They want to come out here and sling some stuff, and we supposed to be impressed. Where's your degree at? A lot of these people with the degrees don't come out and talk about the information and their scholarship. And they actually went to school. They actually have a degree on the wall. And all these loony bins trying to score some points, they want to try to show off. I'm not impressed. I already been through all that. Over 45 years of people trying to flaunt what they read, what they know. So what has it all produced in 45 years? It has produced nothing. So why should we be impressed? I talk to this audience, I talk to you, because you're not dumb. I'm not here to teach you nothing. You already know. Many of you will say, I was just saying the same thing myself, because you're not dumb. The only thing I'm doing is just putting it in this pattern. You're not stupid. You're not dumb. I'm not smarter than you. I'm not better than you. If you want to be impressed by the information, you want to be impressed by the research, then you need to go to Sonetta TV or maybe Tahaka Bay's channel or Tariq Nasheed's. What's they call that? The Debate League, the SVDL, and all these guys. Most of them don't have college degrees or they don't have a bachelor's, they don't have a master's, they don't have nothing. They went to the library. And instead of paying their electric bill, they was buying books. If you into education and scholarship like that, go to damn school. It's a con game. It's part of the con. It's part of the pro-black con game. Not here to con nobody. What you see is what you get. We already have an idea of what control. And there's nothing wrong with control. We need to be controlled. That's why you have a lot of drug addicts and rapists and crime, because something is out of control, something is out of balance to produce these unnatural behaviors, these detrimental behaviors. We have to have control. You can't go driving down your car with your car. And most vehicles have a control arm down to the steering wheels. If that breaks, you lose control. And this wheel goes that way, and another wheel will go another way. You have no control. When there's no control, you have chaos and mayhem. We have to have control. Our body is made of systems. They have to maintain control. When you don't have control, you have a heart attack, stroke. You get diseases, diabetes, cancer. Because something is out of balance. Something is not in control. Kidney failure. So control, there's nothing wrong with control. We have to have law. We have to have control. We have to be in obedience to the law. We have to be in obedience to that control. It's beneficial to us. But there's another side. When control is made corrupt, and this is the problem, that's why we have an International Women's Day, because the control of man, the male gender, has caused women to be in the position that they find themselves in. Because this male has to have this sense of superiority. Now, if you go to the black man and tell him that's white racism is bad, he will agree with you, because white racism is the superiority over the dark. He will agree with you. That ain't right for no white man to think that he's superior over black people. And what did they do? In this country, they made laws to hinder your progress. He lived and crawled over 100 years. And we are taught how inferior we are for hundreds of years in this country. And then with the rise of Nazi Germany and Adolf Hitler teaching and saying the same type of propaganda, mind you, a lot of what the Nazis did, their ideology came from America. They don't like to talk about that a lot, but a lot of their mindset came from America because America was doing it first. And then they had the Olympic Games. And you had people like Jesse Owens and other melanated people, brothers and sisters, that went to the Olympic Games in Germany. And they beat the white man in those games and made Adolf Hitler a liar. This is why women are oppressed, because I don't know where, somewhere in time, some men felt as though they were better. I don't think that's how it started off in the beginning, because human beings was hunters and gatherers. And most of the time, because women have a weaker build, they would stay behind, take care of the children, take care of the family life in the tribe. And men would go out if they were meat eaters and go out and hunt and things of this nature. And women would go out and get the vegetables or, you know, little light stuff, whatever. We knew our roles. And those roles was equal, but somewhere in time, men, I guess they said, man, we going out here, we facing these wild animals out here. We doing more than the women. And we strong anyway. We can beat them up and make them our slave. What can women do? They had to submit to a superior force, like the Africans, like the Haitians, and like all the melanated people around the earth. That's what you did when the Europeans showed up. You began to fall into a superior force, even to this day. Africa's supposed to be melanated. Africa's supposed to be black. Who is in control, really? Other men. And other men would say, Africans and other men, that's wrong. So since you are a weak man and you have to submit to another man, then what happens is this man turns on the woman. And this is what you see all over the earth. Because a dominant man made them submit. Only way they can feel like a man is to enslave women, children, and even the elderly so they can feel like a man. This is what you see all over the earth. All over the earth. Women and children being exploited by men. And what's so sad is young boys raised up in that manner, once they get to a certain point, they're not going to want to fight against something that's wrong. They're going to join the wrongdoers, like many of our people in this country. When it comes to racism, they join the racists, because the racists, they know how to smile now, and you can marry them. And they would give you a $1 million contract. And they'll put your face on TV and your voice on the radio. They will allow you to live the American dream and sell your people out. And you know the history. And you forget and you don't want to think about the history, the lynching and the burning, the discrimination, the humiliation. You don't want to think about that no more because you moved on up to the west side. I finally got a piece of the pie. Control. We was born in control. This is that Janet Jackson said in her lyrics. When I was 17, I did what people told me. I did what my father say and let my mother mold me. So when you don't have control, others dictate and tell you what to do because you don't have any control.
We sell soul food. As a matter of fact, we've been told that Old Henry's is one of the few soul food restaurants in the city of St. Louis, in the state, and in the Midwest. We plan to start our food truck next month.
Okay.
Want that food truck to go all over.
All righty then.
So, and we get the exposure, and we're already taking orders for events. Just took an order for July 31st. We took an order for July 29th. There's a guy who has a construction company. He owns quite a few of them. And we're going to be going to their sites and serving food, serving lunch. And we got a lot of interesting stuff going on.
All right.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome. I'm Angel Snow No Seven. This is my friend.
Ada Taylor.
This is Old Henry Restaurant. If you're ever in the St. Louis area, come check them out. We had a good time just celebrating my sister's birthday, and everything was A-O-T.
All right. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Leaders. This included Lena Horne. This included Dick Gregory. And this included comedians, comics, trumpet players, baseball players. Show me in the white community where a comedian is a white leader. Show me in the white community where a singer is a white leader, or a dancer or a trumpet player is a white leader. These aren't leaders. These are puppets and clowns.
But now she said, I'm growing up. I'm in control. But until you grow up, you don't have control. So women in their rebellion all over the earth, growing up little by little, because you're not gonna get yours. So these men want control of women because they teach and they have conditioned the male gender, not of equality, not this other human being is equal to you, because we all come from her. But we only love her and want her to produce other men. And these are the same people that talk about they don't like gay folks, but that's gay as hell to think that way. You just want to use her to produce more men. And that's what they bring to religion. Allah is a man. Jah is a man, a male. Jesus is a male. Everything about the world of man is male. How you gonna talk about homosexuality when everything that you put your hands on, you make a male out of it? We have men who make statues of penis. That's art. There ain't no art to me. I want no man penis in my house hanging like that. That's art. What kind of man? What kind of man want to draw? And what you use it for, a model yourself? What kind of man want to talk about man all the time? I'm a male. I don't want to see no dangling hanging around. I don't want to see that kind of art. I don't want to see that. They call it art. I don't want to see that. They have statues. Some man that made a statue of a faucet and the penis and the water coming out of it. What the? And these are the same guys that are turning around talking about homosexuality is against God. And they draw men's penises and they call men all day long. Moses is a man. Jesus is a man. Abraham, Lot, the list goes, Paul, the list goes on. All men. Now, when women go to church and hear all these men names, oh, praise Jesus, Paul and Lot, Abraham. A man, and you want to hear men's names all day long. The Honorable Mr. Louis Farrakhan, Malcolm X, Demarcus Garvey, all men constantly. I can't do it. I cannot do it. I want to go to my. You want to join these all men clubs? Ain't no women allowed. What y'all doing? What y'all doing in that club? There's no balance. How are you going to create a world without women? So these men have turned womanhood, you're just a sex object. You're just a toy. You're just a means to an end, and the and the end is the other end of a man. I can't. Oh wow. Because something has gone wrong. Something has gone wrong. Even the devil is a male. Mr. Satan. He's a male. They don't call Satan, Lucifer, a female. Satan is a him too. But because of Eve, and she ate the apple, you know that story. Yeah, but I think the Satan male too. Surrounded by men, nothing but men. Are you serious? Always falling behind men. Watching men booty all the time. Woo. What man want to be around men like that? When I was in the Nation of Islam, every chance I got, I hung out with the MGT, the women. Every chance I got, I don't want to be around men like that. Brothers, you're all right, you know, sometimes or whatever. I don't want to hang around you like that. I don't want to look at no hard leg 24 hours a day. And I guess some of these men, you've never been treated good by a woman in your life, I guess. Some of you have an idea, but you've never been romantically treated good by a woman. Some of us, we've had good women in our lives, our family. You go to grandma's house, you know, Thanksgiving or whatever, and the women do the cooking, and you can watch basketball, and after the game is over, the women got a nice table, good food, and whatever. Some of us never had the experience, a good sister, a good woman, and it's not because I'm the man in the house. It's because she loves you. She see that you're tired from working. And most of the time, hell, she worked too. But she would deny herself for you. Go get your slippers, run your hot bath, and deny herself. But then you should turn around and do the same thing for her, because this is equal. But we are conditioned. This is the way it's supposed to be. Woman's work is called domestic work. Or slave work, slave labor. Men just work. Women's work, cleaning up the house, taking care of the children, they call that domestic labor. Servant labor. You're supposed to serve your man. A slave. How can you be a human being? Hell, what kind of person are you that want a slave like that? What kind of people, what kind of men live in Afghanistan that want to do this to women? You sick. That's a pure mental illness. And so they hang around other men. Like, what? And when other men come to your house, I heard in some of these Islamic nations, when your boys come to the house, the women's supposed to leave the room and go somewhere while you have man company. Now, I do understand to a certain point, because you might have young girls, young daughters, and some of your boys might not have good intentions. They can't control themselves. So I can understand sending the girls or whatever. I can understand it to a certain point, because we got a lot of men who are creeps. We got a lot of men who are predators. You got men who would hit on your wife and your girlfriend. You've been with your girlfriend for 7 years, and you're hitting on your girlfriend, hitting on your wife. Well, that's manhood. That's what we teach. Dick says, male bonding. Ain't enough bonding I want to do with no man. How you doing? What's up? That's good enough. We don't have to. Why you want to be alone with me? You're supposed to be a heterosexual. Why you want to be alone with men like that? And they condition us like that's acceptable behavior. So you can go to Afghanistan and all the men gather together. Now, you know good and well, and you can talk all that homosexual stuff all you want to. Sooner, look, them men being bonded together, and they're not around women like they should be or whatever. For some of these guys, they're going to get turned out. Because they're around men like that. And if you're around men like that long enough, you don't even want no woman like that no more. You ain't even interested. You want to be interested in who you bonding with. Because everything about you, everything that's good is a male. The devil is a male. God is a male. All the prophets of God that mean anything, they have some women prophets, female prophets in the scriptures. They don't mean nothing. They don't even talk about them. They might talk about them twice a year. What's her name? One of the prophets was Ruth, I believe. They don't talk about no Ruth. You can go to any church. They're not talking about no, because they didn't do nothing. The only one who did anything in the scriptures is men. How do we get to this point? We got to this point because somewhere in time, this male gender, regardless, because the original men, they pass this behavior down, and it went on all over the earth. It's very few places that you can probably go where you can actually see male-female equality, especially in civilization. And I don't know why you women brag about civilization. That was the beginning of your oppression, civilization. They put you barefoot and pregnant in civilization. That's your only role, barefoot and pregnant. Bring me some dinner. Take care of my children. That's all you was. A breeder, a slave. It even says in the religious text, and it used to be in the vows when you get married, serve your man. They took that out, I think, nowadays. But it was serve your husband. So a slave, in the Bible, it says that a slave serve a master like you would God. That's what it says in the scriptures. and women whose head have been brainwashed with male superiority.
When soul singer and black activist Sam Cooke wrote the lyrics to his song, A Change Is Gonna Come, it was very direct and to the point. With some changes to it, the song was still digestible. In the year 2019, black folks continue to go through the change rather than direct the change. A community activist named Talik Ibn Rod has made an appeal similar to what Sam Cooke was asking for, a change. It's said that the meek shall inherit the earth. We ask when. When will the landlords give the meek a free lease? Mr. Ebenrod is humbly asking for the state of Mississippi. This is Dusty Basement Studios, and we approve of this message.
The Mississippi campaign represents everything that you claim that you want. The beginning of an all-black independent nation. The ability to control your own resources. Your politics. The law. Be able to do your own thing for a change. Create an economy. Create and produce goods that Africa or anybody on the planet would want. You're fake, you don't want to do nothing. 3 hours talking about the Mississippi campaign. Now this is the 1970s, and they was talking about, these young boys was talking about, yeah man, I'm gonna take my bitch to the movies later on. We gonna go down to the Dairy Queen later on. Take my bitch. I didn't like, he was part of that conversation. Now I did not like that when he was making reference to this young lady as a hoe and a bitch, because I know that's not what she was about. But you know, you want to show off in front of your other friends and the other boys, and they're all, they calling their girlfriends hoes and bitches. They did not talk about, this is my future wife, I love her, this is my hoe, this is my bitch. Now, I did not like that. Now, here are some young teenage boys, including myself. 1970, we calling our sisters hoes and bitches. I did not do that. I've never been that way, never. Where do you think they're getting this from? Some of them got this from watching those black exploitation movies. I never watched those movies. I just recently saw some of those type of films. They watch some of these black exploitation pimp movies. So that's where they got hoes and bitches from. But also grown ass men. Cause I know grown ass men came to me calling sisters hoes and bitches. And they wanted me to do that. And I would not get involved in that type of crap. I've always had respect because that's who raised me. My mother, I view women as very strong. I saw them as stronger than the men around me. My role. I'm not no feminist. I'm not no feminist. I don't believe in that feminism stuff. That's why you're not married. And your husband going around making babies with everything that got a hole in it. He don't care nothing about you. You're just a tool. Most of these women, they're not happy in these marriages. How you gonna be happy as a woman sharing your, whether it's a polygamous marriage or it's just your husband cheating on you and your boyfriend cheating on you? What woman is happy in a relationship like that? Sharing her ding-a-ling with every Tamisha, Donisha, and Harisha in the neighborhood. I see these women, they pretend like they're happy. Who is happy about sharing body fluids with other folks? Disgusting. But when they caught up in the male superiority thing, and that's acceptable for him, don't you do it. You're supposed to be a virgin. You will be clean and holy for him. He's a dirt bag. He's a piece of crap that anything in the neighborhood didn't have. And you're supposed to save yourself and be a virgin for him. Y'all don't see something wrong with that picture? He can go out and be in all the garbage he wants to. And sow his seeds. And you supposed to sit around and try to protect your virginity and wait on Mr. Piece of Trash Charming show up. I'm ready to settle down now. I got babies all over the 48 states and I'm ready to settle down now. And then he still cheat on you. He still will abuse you. He still will lie to you. And you save yourself. Think you special. You're not special in the eyes, in the minds of these men that have been conditioned like this. Not only in America, but around the earth. They only love men. They only love men. So somewhere in time, the woman was broken. You was domesticated. And I would say that the female was the first human slave. The first slave was plants. Then, of course, you know, fish, animals. But the first human slave had to be female. The first human slave. And somewhere in time, they broke you. And it's acceptable. Just like when you put that leash on your dog. Very few dogs will fight the leash because that's your pet. That's all they know. Are we going for a walk? The tail get the wagon. That's all they know. They domesticated animals. Under control of a master. You love that word. These men love that word. Submission. You got to submit. Submission. They love that. I don't want no black woman. I'm going to go to Asia. I'm going to go somewhere overseas because those women know how to submit to their man. They like that because it's all about control. Control for the benefit of who? Not for the woman. Control for the what is in the best interest or what this corrupt male wants. Don't give a damn about you. So we have a horse. And the horse is wild. You try to ride the horse. And it starts bucking. Get off my back. But then, when you break that horse, they put a bridle in the mouth connected to a harness, the reins. And how you pull those reins, you can make that horse go to the left, go to the right, stop and go. Put a bridle in the mouth. When you get married, what do they call you? Woman? They call you a bride. Call you a bride. Bridal. A bride. And they put that bride in your mouth. Because you're married in the house of religion. And they put the word of God in your mouth. That's your bridal. And most of you are controlled by religious. And this is why you tolerate your oppression, your mistreatment, and the injustice that's been done to you. Because they put a bridle in your mouth, which is religion. And it's the harness they use to control because that's what God wants. And they know how to pull the harness to the left, to the right, and make you stop, make you go. And you will even fight against anybody standing up for you. This channel should have thousands of women. I don't care about the men. I don't need no men around me. I don't need no men around me. I should have thousands and thousands of women simply because I will stand up for you and I will walk with you and I will fight with you. So that you can be equal. So that you can be a human being. You're not a damn sex toy. But because there's a bridle in your mouth, you actually support those who want to keep you in a subservient position. And you got a smile on your face when you get married. You just been buck broke like the horse. Feminism is nothing but a consequence and a result of those women who rebel against the programming. I don't have to tolerate that. I don't have to tolerate being treated like a second-class citizen, a subhuman. That's where it comes from. Now, when these Caucasian men was under the domination of the mother country, they understood all that. But once they got out from under the control, out from under the control of England, Great Britain, now they want to become the oppressor. They want to oppress their women, and they want to oppress the black slaves. Because now I'm in control. And they and being in control comes with a lot of perks. Comes with a lot of benefits. I like that. A lot of these men, they know that women are oppressed, but you know, hey, I like the perks. Just like the races. They know that racism, they know that it's corny, it's out of date or whatever, but if I'm a white man in a racist society, hey, it comes with a lot of perks. They're not gonna really fight against it because there's a lot of benefits. Having white skin in a racist society. And so you have men, they like, especially if you're a black man and you're a nobody, you don't have no power, you don't have no control. Well, the simple fact I got a ding-a-ling, that give me, you know, a little something over, you know, over black women, because you know, I got a ding-a-ling, you know. And they like that. And God do favor Adam over Eve, you know. You know that book that you claim that God gave you, but God really didn't give to you, that you made up? And that's the bridle you put in their mouth, and many, and they believe it. I'm supposed to submit to my man. It says right there in the Bible. It's right there in the Holy Quran. That men wrote. That men wrote. And these religious books is nothing. It's all about men. But at the same time, we just had Black History Month. Why is there a Black History Month? Because black people should know about their history outside of listening, reading about white folks all the time. Shouldn't the same thing be done with women? Where in the scriptures will we be talking about women? But in the scriptures, in the Holy Quran and in the Bible, women don't do nothing. I don't understand a woman that want to sit under a teaching and you don't do nothing. And when you do become a minister, you talk about what men did. So what's the sense of being a female minister in a church or a mosque or a synagogue, and the only thing you're going to do is get up and talk about men? Where you at? Where your gender? What do women do? Nothing. These same black men will tell you it's wrong. We should know that black people have done more than been on a slave plantation, and they want to tell you about the great history of black people all over the earth. And when they tell you, it's going to be about men too. Got a few women out there, whatever, a few queens. But basically, it's about it's everything. Everything in recorded history is about. You couldn't be so. You couldn't be so. You couldn't be so.
You couldn't be so.
I'd gladly pay you Tuesday for a hamburger today.
Like straight up. That's where I'm at with it. Now I'm to the point where I want to kill Operation Exodus Mississippi.
You have offended my family, and you have offended the Shaolin Temple.
I'd gladly pay you Tuesday for a hamburger today.
Hell, you can even bring your Bible brother, literally and figuratively, Talia. I'd crush his ass too, because he do the same thing you do.
Somebody done told him wrong.
Or don't hit back.
I'd gladly pay you Tuesday for a hamburger today.
Some people just like talking out their ass. 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 That's what they like to do.
He's forever and always. My black people, it's all about the unity. There's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody moving.
Black people, it's all about the unity. There's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody moving. All kinds of, why do y'all want the drugs? You want the drugs because smoking cigarettes make you feel good. Drinking beer make you feel good. Crack cocaine make you feel good. Meth make you feel good. The drugs give you pleasure. The drugs make you feel good. That's why they do it. Give me some beer. Give me some alcohol. Give me some liquor. Give me some weed. I gotta get away from this too much. Going on, much, 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 going on.
Greetings. I'm Tangelika Cox. I had the pleasure of speaking with Talik Ibn Rod, and you know, he has a movement / ministry by the name of the Reality Temple on Earth. And I had the pleasure of speaking with him for several hours today, and I think it's only fair that I do a reaction video to the conversation. And the conversation was on various topics, which was basically centered around African quote-unquote consciousness. And he was a real deep brother, very down to earth, very approachable. He didn't carry himself like a know-it-all, someone you could talk to and really listen to you. It was such an honor to finally meet somebody over the internet that has a ear to listen, and not only an ear to listen, but will take full action on what they stand for. And I appreciate it, having that conversation with you, and I do look forward to working with you. Why would you want to hear that about men all the time? If you're a woman, don't you want to hear about your... Don't you want to see yourself here? So what is your value? You have none. You have none. So International Women's Day is a day where women who have broken out the matrix. I'm not asking you for $1 million. I just want to be treated like a human being. And that's all Dr. King wanted. Our people did marching in the civil rights movement. They didn't want nothing special. I work for mine. I'm not asking you for no freebies. Just leave me the hell alone. Just treat me like a human being. I'm not asking you to go beyond and do me anything special. Like some folks in this country, I'm not going to touch on that though. Some folks, because they are who they are, they want special treatment because. But that's all. That's just all I want. So again, you also have striving, trying to fight for their humanity, but then you have those just like
with racism, you have those who take us backwards. You have International Women's Day, Women's History Month, and while I'm talking, you have women on strip poles, and you got women on the streets selling their bodies. And you got women at home submitting to their husband in the name of Allah. That's detrimental to the rise of your gender. But I can understand why some women are in the strip clubs and prostitution, and some of them are doing what they do because they don't have no control. So if I'm going to survive and I don't have a good education, let me find a man that will take care of me and let me submit to him and try to be a decent wife. Maybe I can divorce him and take half or something like that. Use my body. You got to use your body. Because you don't control nothing. There's no woman in their right mind that want to be a damn stripper. There's no woman in their right mind want to be a prostitute. They ain't never heard no little girl when she playing with her little Barbie dolls. When I grew up, I want to be a stripper. I want to be a prostitute. This is the condition that men have put women where they don't have too much of a choice, because men control all the resources. They control the jobs. They control the necessities of life. And they are corrupt. And really, no matter how women rise, without men like myself, men who love women, who view you as a mother, and who see you as a human being, without us, your rise is going to be slow or it will never happen, because it takes a man to deal with another man. Even if that man have to go to war, I'm going to free you like the Civil War. Men had to go to war. That's what caused these slaves to be set loose from these plantations, because it took a white man to deal with a white man. And if these women really gonna be free, if they're really gonna get their humanity, it's gonna take men to deal with these corrupt men and destroy that which is unnatural and bring the natural back. Because this, how we living, clearly is unnatural. Clearly it is. When you are a male and the only thing you want to do is be surrounded by other men, something the hell is wrong with you. You want to always walk looking at another man's backside walking down the street. But that's not gay. I want to say this in conclusion. If you expect humanity to evolve in the best manner that we can be, if you want humanity to reach our highest potential, you got to be good to mama. You got to be good to the woman. She's the key. When I was in the Nation of Islam, they taught us when a woman get pregnant, you got to give her the best. Make sure she's happy all the time. She's comfortable all the time. because she's carrying you. She's carrying our life. There's a lot of criminals in the world, drug addicts, dope fiends, riffraff, because that's what you making her produce. We're making her produce. She's a slave and she produced more slaves. So you should not be a shock. That's how we find the earth. You cause her to produce these things because she's going to duplicate herself, and she's a slave, so she's going to produce slaves. But when you put her in a better position, this is mother. The only way we can go into the future is through her. That's the only way you can see the future. The only thing a man can do is help produce a child. You can't carry a child for 9 months. You can't nurture and develop a child. You don't have the tools. The only thing you can do is help. So the scriptures got it backwards. The man, the male, is the helpmate to the woman, not vice versa. And you happy to help. Man, I'm sure, man. I can't wait till that live stream over. I got to do me some shooting. And you happy. You happy to help. But what we've been doing to this woman, this male gender, what has been done to her, and I'm going to talk to the male gender, regardless to your race, all over the earth, what you have done to her is wrong. And you brag about your little accomplishments, your little space shuttle, and your other little technology. And she's able to produce other human beings that's able to give us these things. Can you imagine what this woman can do for us as a species, as human beings, if we gave her the honor and put her in the correct environment, the incredible genius that will come from her womb? She will no longer produce slaves. She will begin to produce human beings, and in religious texts, from human being to God. You don't hear me though. Before you can become God, you got to be a human being first. You're not even on that level yet. And you will never become a human being till you treat her right. Till you put her on the throne, put her in the position where she needs to be. Love her. She's not a tool. She's not a cow. She's not a chicken. She's your friend. She's your mama. Real men should not tolerate women being treated the way they've been treated all these generations, eons. The buck needs to stop here now. Free your mind, and the rest will follow. On that note, thank you for listening. Jot down your comments, subscribe, all that kind of good stuff. Again, happy International Women's Day. Happy Women's History Month. We need that. Real men need to stand up for mom. And I know that we complain about women, but we've done this to ourselves. We've done this. The male gender has done this. Once you straighten ourselves up and put her on the right track, everything would be different. Everything would change. Through her womb, we will create the heaven on earth described in your scriptures. Through her womb comes, as the Quran say, the hereafter. Until you treat her right, you ain't gonna get it right. I thank you for your time. It's always an honor to come before you. Thank you to everybody in the chat room, Brother Talib, Alma Delight, Mellow Cap, Because of Reality. I saw Zaba the Midget, Dorian. Please, Facebook and Instagram. Please don't think that I am ignoring you. I'm just not that tech savvy. I don't know how to keep I can't watch Facebook and Instagram, and my primary is of course YouTube. But I appreciate you being here and listening to us tonight. Share, subscribe, support our vision of what we call Operation Exodus Mississippi campaign. You want to learn more about it? Look up the videos. Everything that we're doing, check out the description box. Also, shout out to our people in London, England, Just Acting and The Resident, our sister Tangi and Josiah and Leah, India, in California, and all our people all over this earth, men and women, regardless to race. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. I really appreciate it. And out of all our videos, this month, share this one. And if I'm incorrect, please tell me, because I don't want to be just drifting in la la land. But I truly feel I'm correct because I'm standing up for another human being that's oppressed, and justice needs to be given to those of whom have been oppressed and done unjust. What is wrong with that?
I'm very proud of her for her accomplishments, and I think more than anything else is that she's remained grounded. She's still Terry, you know. She still comes home and washes dishes, and she's still hungry all the time. So, you know, she hadn't really changed at all, with the exception of, I think she likes what she's doing a little bit more. I think she's on time for quite a few gigs because she has David to take care of if she doesn't show up on time. So it's a little bit different now, but we're all extremely proud of her. And I think she looks at it more of a blessing as opposed to a talent. And we see it as a job, so we just kind of keep her sane when she comes home as opposed to the glitz and glamour. So she knows that she's comfortable. She can come home and kick back, not worry about it, just be a Southern girl.
YouTube. This is Tangelika the Black Sheep. I am welcoming you to join me on my new YouTube page where I'll be discussing motivational Angelica the Black Sheep.
In the name of my ancestors, peace forever and always.
Soulflower, I always said it was a gumbo of a mixture of different genres of music. A touch of neo-soul, a little bit of the old En Vogue vibe, R&B.
You got my head spinning around. You got my feet off the ground.
Still today, in 2004, has a contemporary edge to it. And it's En Vogue.
Muhammad. What are we talking about organization for? Ain't no organization of nothing.
Exactly.
Ain't no organization of OEM. Ain't no organization of OES. Exactly. So why are we talking about organization?
Right. So how are you going to be the president of something that don't exist?
I'm a president in my own mind.
Okay. All right.
You have offended my family. And you have offended the Shaolin Temple. You have offended my family, and you have offended the Shaolin Temple.
Hey everybody, it's Women's History Month. We're just sitting here talking about who we want to highlight, commemorating and remembering brilliant women who were trailblazers in women's history. And congratulations to all of the women who have paved the way and blazed the trail. Thank you for your excellence. Thank you for the inspiration.
We have incredible Nobel Prize winner Toni Morrison.
Poets like Phyllis Wheatley and Maya Angelou. Hopefully we're making some type of mark in women's history. Musicians like Celia Cruz and Ella Fitzgerald and Sarah Vaughan. I mean, you know the list will go on. And lots of women to remember during this Women's History Month. So shout out to all this beautiful feminine energy paving the way for all ladies.
And as always in parting, we wish you...
Come on and jam with us next week on these same stations. And you can bet your last money it's all going to be a stone gas, honey. I'm Don Cornelius, and as always in parting, we wish you love, peace, and soul.